Upon his appointment as the Attorney General of Malaysia, Tommy Thomas promised that when it comes to people he may have known when he was in private practice, where conflict of interest arises, he will immediately recuse himself from the issue involving these people. In fact, even on his first day after clocking in, Thomas assured that among his first priorities is to study instances of selective prosecution. However, is it too much of a coincidence that just under 100 days since Pakatan wrested Putrajaya, numerous cases involving Pakatan leaders, whether in courts or already determined by the courts, have either been dropped, withdrawn, acquitted, call it what you may, but they all tilt in favour of Pakatan. Consider these cases. On 19 May 2018, the Armed Forces Fund Board withdrew its suit against former PKR Pandan MP Rafizi Ramli. On 28 June, the Sessions Court acquitted and discharged PKR Sungai Buloh MP Siva Rasa from two charges of uploading a fake Time magazine cover of Dato' Sri Najib Razak on his Facebook page 2 years ago, after the Malaysian Communication and Multimedia Commission withdrew the charges against Siva Rasa. On 2 July 2018, Felda Global Ventures Holdings Sendirian Berhad conceded to an appeal by Deputy Prime Minister Dr. Wan Azizah and Suara Keadilan. FGV absolved PKR and Wan Azizah from paying the RM2 million in damages for defamation ordered by the court. On 25 July 2018, it was rumoured that the Attorney General will withdraw corruption charges against Guan Eng. Isn't this a contradiction of Tommy Thomas' own words to recuse himself from cases involving conflict of interest? In fact, is Guan Eng's current counsel, DAP Bukit Gelugor MP Ram Kapal Singh, contradicting himself when he said that the independence of Tommy Thomas would still be intact if he considers the case representation of Guan Eng and Pang Lee Kun to withdraw the corruption charges at the Penang High Court? Isn't it another coincidence that the Penang High Court has now delayed Guan Eng's and Pang Lee Kun's graft trial to 3rd September 2018, pending the withdrawal of the case by the Attorney General? Why this special treatment for Guan Eng when he did not even have to appear in court despite being on bail? On the 30th of July 2018, Zuna, former PKR Padang Serai MP Surendran and Siva Rasa acquitted and discharged of all sedition charges. Malaysian courts are known for their backlog in cases. Isn't it another coincidence that not even 100 days of Pakatan rule have passed? Yes, at least 10 criminal cases or civil suits involving Pakatan leaders have now been either dropped or no longer pursued by the Attorney General's chambers. The speed and expediency in which charges on Pakatan leaders have been withdrawn is simply amazing.